every time coming back is stressful because it reminds me back the competition in a way. Definitely from the piano trying, it was easier this time. There's only two choices of Stanway, so that makes the life a lot easier. And yeah, because here we are in Sofitel, and it's actually the hotel I was staying in preliminary round. So yeah, that's where it started basically. Yeah, when I come back, it all, you know, remind me the bad or the good experiences, but it's all there. This interview we did right after the result, and yeah, because I was like so tired, you know, after 2 hours of sleep. So it's not a blame on you. It's just bad memories, but with time everything becomes really memorable in a way. Not really specific. Even just, you know, walking on what was that street? A Nova Sviat or something? Yeah, a lot of restaurants, you know, eating there. And you know, at the end, I met all the competitors more at the end of the competition. But before that, I was really in my, you know, in my own bubble. So it's just different, you know. Just preparing the fact in the practice room itself. Now it's something precious for me now because I think I don't practice enough anymore since the win. And you know, it's like I really miss the past sometimes. So my life was, I lost 4 kilograms, and then I went back home, I gained 4 kilograms, and now we are starting back the tour, so I'm gonna lose again. So yeah, that's pretty much my life. Yeah, no, because I never thought that going on tour was such a demanding job, you know. It's not really, you know, it's like physically it's weird because we are eating at restaurants every time, so logically we should gain weight, right? And but actually, you know, with all the travels and all the jet lag, and you know, I'm not that stressed, you know, but it's still all the process, you know, running from there to there. So you know, at the end, it's from the fact itself, you can see it's quite a demanding job. So when I'm home, you know, that my dad feed me like a beer, you know, so I can be ready to go again. When I'm home, it's still the same. You know, I try to. Now I think it is very important because in the past I was always, you know, during the pandemic year, I was dreaming of traveling, of all these, you know, projects and stuff. So right now my dream is to stay at home, you know, to stay in this to stay in my corner and stay calm, which is less. You know, we always want something that we don't have really. So it's too bad, but it's fun. It's like daily routine in a travel places, it's gonna be like that. So like arriving at airport, you know, and just run to the hotel, and then I will take a nap all the time because it's you know, the sleep quality is just very bad during travel. So, and then just, you know, prepare the concert at night, and of course no dinner because usually the concerts are at night and I don't really eat too closely. So dinner is usually after the concert, which is probably midnight. So this is how it goes in the concert day. And of course, banana before the concert. But in a normal day, yeah, I mean, just wake up at 11, you know, chill. And yeah, probably no breakfast, just a lunch. And then I try to swim in the afternoon, you know, and practice a bit, you know, and walks in some parks, or also try to cook at home. Finally, is a very healthy habit. Yeah, it depends where, you know. I think because of the fact that I have a very mixed background, you know, like I was born in France and originally Chinese, and then I grew up in Canada. So I think it's good that I don't have too much craziness in one place, like Sanjin. So at least I don't have to, you know, to wear mustache or glasses. Maybe in China, but you know, it's like right now it's all closed there. So we will see in 2 years if they still recognize me. I think yes, but at least, you know, it's I will say the craziness is shared between the territory. Yeah, of course, since this summer will do. Because, you know, the artistic planning is so far away, and we're planning already stuff from 24, 25 even, you know. And, so yeah, Chopin will be always there, with little changes, you know, but it will of course not disappear. That's not my that's not my intention. It's just to tell people that, you know, that actually I started with my teacher, not Chopin, you know, who is a winner 40 years ago, and it's crazy that we didn't even play it, I mean, learn Chopin until 2 years before, you know, the competition. And so that just to say that, you know, he and I are both, you know, loving other stuff too. Well, right now I'm already going to play Rameau and Ravel, you know, French music a lot, and it's still kind of related with Chopin, you can say.